Now it's 3 days after my surgery, and I'm in for my first follow-up. And I had to talk to this gentleman that was waiting in the waiting room as well.
How are you?
Good. I'm jealous that you just flew right in here.
It's my second one.
Is it really? Like the two ladies that were in here before, he had great insight. And one thing, he just whisked right into the office. I couldn't believe how fast he walked in his boot.
You know, you feel a little bit cautious about it. You keep it up and you mm-hmm. do a lot of things you probably won't do the second time. Mm-hmm. It's wonderful.
I miss running already. It's only day three.
it goes fast. Yeah. It really does. You'll be up running around in this boot here and you'll feel like you're able to do some stuff.
Uh-huh.
So it'll be fun. Because I've seen people that haven't had to do, been able to do that. So, and I've got somebody that's at work who just had one done. And she's jealous I'm not running around like this.
Right, like me right now.
Yeah.
I saw you fly in here.
Maybe today.
Huh? Yeah. Yeah. And how long has it been for this one?
10 days.
Oh, so you're getting your stitches out today.
I am. Oh. And 2 days from there, I'll be able to have a shower without a boot on.
And are you athletic?
I am. I mountain bike and run and jump horses.
Oh, I do all that except for the horses.
You'll be able to do all that here real shortly.
Oh, yeah. I'm thinking, 2-3 months I'll be able to do all that again? With both feet, yeah.
Yeah, that's right, because you're going to have both of them done.
Doing both.
Yeah, I'm looking at probably December.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm looking forward to it. And you will, too. It'll be good.
It's going to be the kickoff of my new year.
There you go. It's a great time to plan it.
Yeah.
So you can start off with a good year.
Yeah. So how is that foot, the one that's already complete?
It's good. You know, I have as much range, I have more range of motion, and I have no pain.
Uh-huh.
And I had a bone spur and a bunion. So I had two things that they took care of.
Wow.
So it's really feeling really great. And this has been 7-8 weeks now. And so I actually was out.
This is the confession area.
I actually got out on a bike. So,
did you?
Just before I had this one done,
uh-huh.
I just had this craving. So I went out for a real easy bike ride, and it was fine.
Yeah, see, I think that would be fine, a bike.
Yeah.
Because you're not really pounding on the feet. It's more of a turn.
Yeah, I didn't try to run. Mm-hmm. But I do, I put my tennis shoe on, and I've done a lot of walking around. I've helping to coach a girls' soccer team.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, just kind of bouncing around a little bit, not much.
Yeah.
How'd you find Dr. Moy?
A friend of mine, but I do have to say that it's been probably 2-3 years I initially had surgery scheduled.
Oh.
And I interviewed 5 doctors, roughly, mm-hmm. you know, from orthopedics to
sure.
Podiatrists, and I wasn't satisfied. Their consultations just weren't warming enough. I didn't feel the confidence.
Mm-hmm.
I did with one orthopedic, and he's the one that I actually scheduled the surgery with. And then I just decided, you know what, I'm not ready for this. You know, it's a kind of a combination of not being ready, being scared,
mm-hmm.
and then just not feeling 100% confident with him.
Sure.
And I have to say, with Dr. Moy's presentation, the way he shows how it's actually done and showing the graphics and all that,
mm-hmm.
that's the best presentation I've ever seen. So I was convinced after talking to his patients, too.
That's great. I had two people in the office that had Dr. Moy do do the surgery for them, and I said, "You sure?" And actually, one had just had it done,
mm-hmm.
and they said all those things about how Dr. Moy took care of it and didn't have a problem, had no pain. And so I said, "Well, you know what? I need to get it done." And so I just kind of planned it to have it done about this time,
yeah.
So that I'd be at the first of the year being able to go skiing and
exactly,
get
me
back
too.
Into everything else. Yeah,
same way.
So. No, it's been, it couldn't be perfectly, more perfectly planned than what I already did with everything. And having two people from the office have the same surgery,
mm-hmm.
it's been wonderful to know that.
Yeah. So. My stepmother has had it done in Nebraska, and she sent me an email yesterday. And she says, "I'm told, and from my recollection, the third day is the worst when you're in pain." And I email her back, I go, "No, no pain," in all caps.
That's right. That's right.
Not here.
No, I haven't yet at all.
Yeah.
So.
This guy was great, wasn't he?
Kimber, come on over. We're going to get you some x-rays. I'm just going to have you take your shoe off there.
Mm-hmm.
drop your foot right up here. Now with this one, I'm just going to have you step straight down here on this plate, nice and flat with your toes up here on the light.
Good.
And with this one, I'm going to have you tilt your foot inward just like this. Just roll. All right, that's it. You're all set. How you doing?
Good.
Good.
So after the x-rays, Jordan takes me into the room where he proceeds to take off my shoe and the sock.
I'm just going to take your bandages off here for you, get your foot cleaned up.
Now, this is a really big moment for me because it's the first time I'm going to get to see my foot.
Have you been taking it easy on your foot?
Yeah, I'd say for the most part. I've been icing, you know, every hour for about 15 minutes.
Good.
So seeing that blood is normal?
A little bit of blood is normal. The good thing is that it's dry. That means that probably right when they let the tourniquet down, the blood rushing back into your foot bled out just a little bit into the bandage. Mm-hmm. If it were wet, it would be a concern, but it's... This is all old, just good.
It is kind of wild to not see that bump on there.
Yeah.
Wow.
These little pieces of tape are called stereo strips. They're like band-aids. They stick a little bit, but it doesn't hurt at all when they come off.
One thing Jordan does is each move that he makes, he does a thorough explanation of everything that he's doing and why he's doing it.
You doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
Look different?
It does. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's amazing.
Just going to clean it up here a little bit. This is just hydrogen peroxide.
Now, it was really something to see my foot. Even when the bandages were still on my foot, I could see that that bunion had disappeared. To see that I no longer have that large bump that would cause pain, for it to be gone. That's exciting.
I'm just going to cut the little end of this suture here. It looks like a fishing line here. This is all extra. I just don't want you to think it's a hair and pull on it. Mm-hmm. I'll do the same thing right up here by your toe. This suture here goes in at one end of the incision and zigzags back and forth. It's all underneath your skin, comes out at the other end, and that's why we leave these two pieces of tape on to keep the tension on that suture. Mm-hmm. And that helps to keep the skin closed.
Now, I do want to share with you that I actually had my surgery 10 days ago, literally. I mean, check it out. Still got the boot on. And I have not felt any pain. So the mere fact of not seeing that bone there and looking forward to the fact of not feeling that pain is remarkable. And I remember interviewing all those patients and them saying the exact same thing I'm saying to you right now. And you can't help but have a little bit of doubt, you know, is it really going to be true for me? Am I going to be that exception that feels pain? Well, guess what? No, I don't feel any pain.
So I'm going to have Dr. Moy come in, take a look at your foot, and we'll get you all wrapped back up.
All right.
Okay. Just a couple minutes. Hi, Kimber.
Hi there.
How you doing?
I'm good.
So how'd it go after surgery, all right?
Yeah, I got around a lot better than I thought I would.
Good. Once the numbness wore off, did you have any discomfort at all?
Nope.
No?
If anything, just feel a little tingly like it fell asleep or something.
Okay, yeah. Good. Well, Jordan took the dressings off, I see. It looks great. There's hardly any bruising, very little swelling. Let's see if we grab that toe a little bit and bend it.
See? It makes me nervous.
I know. And see, that doesn't hurt, which is pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just get nervous.
A lot of people are apprehensive when you do that, but mm-hmm. it's just to show you it doesn't really hurt at all. Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're just going to stereo-strip this back up and wrap your foot back up, and Jordan's going to go over with you also how to remove the stitches in about 2 weeks from the day of your surgery.
Okay.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Do you have any questions for me at all?
No. Not yet. I mean, if anything, it's just been amazing that I've been able to walk around, you know, and get around and take care of myself in my hotel even.
Well, that's good. And you're going to find that it's going to be a lot easier to get around once you have that gray boot on your foot, because you'll be able to roll forward slightly on your foot instead of trying to keep the weight off of
it.
Oh,
great.
Yeah, so okay. You're going to get around a lot easier with that. Okay, Kimber, I'm going to show you your x-rays now. We have them up here on the view box.
Now Dr. Moy is here showing me my x-rays after surgery, and you can see that the screw is in my foot, holding everything together. And looking at these and having him explain in more detail as to how that works, just again, it confirms why I chose Dr. Moy, because his skill level is so precise.
And you see, you do have the screw there. The head of the first metatarsal is right where it needs to be, right here. And your bones are centered right where they need to be, one on each side of the center line, if this was a center line right through here. And there's the screw. This view here is the best view to look at when in terms of seeing the significance of the bunion, because we tilt your foot like this a little bit to take this particular x-ray. And that shows the bone not only growing out to the side, but slightly above or up like this direction. So when you tilt it like this, it sticks out the most. And as you see, there is absolutely no bone sticking off to the edge of the side right here. Okay, and then if I were to look at the side view, you know, the interesting thing about the screw and how nice it works is that the bone is cut from here to this point here. It stops right here and comes out in that direction there, so it draws like an L-shaped bone cut. And when you put that screw in there, it compresses the bone so tightly together we can't even see where the bone's cut. It actually looks like it's already healed. And it will stay looking like that through the entire healing process. So we get primary bone healing. There's no shifting of bone around. Because when the bone tends to shift, you get a lot of bone callus or bone growth around that site. But it will stay remaining looking like that. And of course, there's the head of your screw, and it does stick up above the bone just to here, just a little bit. But that screw is perfectly placed in there. Okay? So everything looks great on x-ray.
Great.
All right? Okay, so Jordan, go ahead and wrap her foot up and get her in her gray boot. And we have a little video also that we'll have you watch regarding the application of the boot as well.
Okay.
Okay?
Great.
All right, we'll have a safe trip back home, okay?
Thanks.
And don't forget, we're always here. You can call us, email us if you'd like, and we're always available that way, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Great.
All right.
Thanks.
Sure. This is just a little of the adhesive here. This is going to help the Steri-Strip stick to your foot. These little Steri-Strip bandages are just going to help reinforce the incision. This helps to reduce scarring while it's healing. We're going to have you leave these on until 2 weeks from the day of your surgery, so it'll be about another week and a half. And that's when you're going to remove the sutures. The way you do that is by pulling these pieces of tape off away from the incision. That'll expose that little fishing line looking string that I showed you.
Mm-hmm.
That's your suture. It's an absorbable suture material, and it goes in at one end of the incision and zigzags back and forth all the way down to the other end, and we pull it taut and put these pieces of tape on there to keep the skin closed. So what you'll do is peel these away from the incision, take that piece of string and pull on it slightly, just a few millimeters, to have it come out of your skin. And then you'll cut it as close to the skin as possible, okay? That way the rest of the suture will sink back underneath the surface of your skin. You'll do that on both sides. Make sure that you do not leave a little bit of that suture material sticking out like a whisker, okay? You want to pull it out enough so that when you cut it, the rest of it will sink back underneath. Mm-hmm. You do that on both sides, and then you replace these stereo strips here like I'm doing. This is called polysporin powder. So it's a little bit of an antibiotic powder.
Jordan came in and he began to thoroughly explain to me how I was going to work with my foot when it's time to clip the sutures. And basically when that's done, you clip the tips of it, and he shows you how. And then what's remaining under the skin absorbs into the body. It's really quite simple. And this is perfect for those who are out of town or out of state.
Because we put the bandage on snugly to add a little bit of compression and help to keep some of the swelling out of the area. But when your foot does swell inevitably, it makes the bandage that much tighter. So that first night we have you cut it just a little bit down this way, and that helps relieve a little bit of that tension. You shouldn't experience it this time when I'm putting this bandage on, because your foot is already swelled slightly and this bandage won't be quite as tight. How does that feel?
Good.
Does it feel nice and snug?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Doesn't feel too tight though, right?
I don't think so.
Okay. If you do notice that this bandage starts to get tight again, if you're on your foot a lot and again your foot starts to swell a lot, then go ahead and cut it just how you did the last time, just about halfway down, right on the top of the bandage, and that'll help relieve some of that tension.
Okay.
We'll give you a sock here, then we're going to give you this gray boot that we're going to have you wearing for the next few weeks. But what we're going to have you doing in this gray boot is walking flat,
uh-huh.
And that crease is partly caused from the bandage and partly caused from the way you're walking. You're walking on this side of your foot.
Right, and that squishes it.
Yeah, that squishes it, exactly. So in this gray boot, you're going to step flat on it and walk normally on
it. Be better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you this sock here. Get this out of here, and I'll let you down. You can put this gray boot back on. If you have a seat right over here in this chair, you need to strap this on. All right, Kimber, so you saw the video. You saw how to put the boot on.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to have you do it here, and I'm going to watch you.
Okay.
So go ahead and unstrap it and pull that shell off. Your pump, there's a set of instructions that the company gives you with that.
Okay.
So you can take those away.
Now, the last thing of my follow-up visit, I'm given my boot. This boot is very simple to put on. Jordan showed me how to do it, and then I proceeded to show him that I could do it. And I'll tell you, when I saw Robin, the gentleman that I saw in the lobby, when he walked in his, because he had his boot on, he just moved with ease. And since my operation, I have actually been wearing the boot, and it's true. You don't need crutches. It literally lets your foot roll with the ground, whereas when you're wearing the shoe, it's flat. So the boot is a lifesaver. Does that turn good?
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Great.
And when you stand up on there, you're going to notice it has what they call a rocker bottom. It has a curved sole on it so that you can actually roll forward on the boot without bending your toes.
Okay.
Okay. Where in the other shoe, in the shoe that you got right after surgery, you have to walk on your heel and on the side of your foot. In this boot, you can step flat down onto your foot. Okay. And you can walk with a more normal gait because the boot will allow you to roll forward.
Okay.
Okay. So go ahead and stand up on there, see how it feels.
Oh, it's comfortable.
Good. Now you're going to want to find a shoe for your other foot that's similar in height,
mm-hmm.
so that you're not walking lopsided.
Okay.
Okay. But in this boot, like I said, you can walk pretty much normal.
Okay.
Okay.
Great.
All right.
And after that, I'm done. And as an out-of-towner, I'm not due to see Dr. Moy until 6 more weeks for my right foot. Now that you've seen the entire process, please take my word. this is virtually pain-free. Not just my foot, because I'm telling you, I feel no pain, but the entire process has been pain-free. And I mean that in the sense that everyone that I worked with in Dr. Moy's office, it's been a pleasure. They've been professional, they've been funny, and I go in and I actually feel like I have new friends, and I'll be back because I'm having my right foot done. I've talked to a lot of patients, and I'm talking to you right now. I hope that you will consider having Dr. Moy do your bunion surgery. It'll be worth it. Good luck.